One of the things I love about cycling is how it brings people from all walks of life together and builds community. This trip to Finland is not about the race result. It's about the journey and where the bike takes me.
I woke up to the morning sky first. Baby blue, just like we rehearsed.
Guys, ready?
When I get up off this ground, I shake leaves back down to the brown, 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 till I'm clean.
To start off the trip, I headed over to Alchemy, and Robert and Jared helped me get set up on a size large Lycos demo bike. I typically ride a size XL, so to compensate, they put on a setback seat post and kind of flipped the stem so it was up a little bit higher, and yeah, worked out great. Then I packed up my bike and I was off to Helsinki the next day. I arrived at my Airbnb pretty late Thursday evening, so I just got some rest, and I was up pretty early on Friday building up my bike. So we're out, we're gonna go check out a coffee shop. One that I've heard a lot about called Kahawe. I think I'm pronouncing that right.
And hopefully I have some pretty good coffee. Got a couple flat whites, let's see how they are.
Yeah, it's super good coffee. I'm not kidding, it was one of the best cappuccinos I've had in my life. So if you're in the Lahti area, I'd highly recommend checking out that shop.
Some of the best coffee I've had, honestly. And now we're gonna go pick up the race packet and still try to find someone to pump up those tires.
Both my tires were flat from pressuring down from the airplane, and I was looking for a bike pump, and that's where I ran into Patrick at Schwalbe.
How's your day going?
Oh, it's already started.
Yeah.
Right now I'm fresh.
That's good.
And he shared a ton of knowledge just about tire pressure and tires in general. Shout out to Patrick, super thankful. And it just reminded me how cool it is to meet new people while traveling and how friendly and helpful a lot of people are in the bike industry. So shout out to Patrick and the whole Schwalbe crew. Y'all are a rad bunch. And after that, I went out and rode the course a little bit just to get a feel for it. I wanted to, you know, see what the first sort of 10 miles were of the course, just to kind of know what I was getting myself into. This was my first ever time riding a gravel bike, minus the one day before that I left. I just rode around my apartment a little bit on some trails nearby, and I just wanted to get a good feel for the bike, the track, and yeah, it was beautiful.
It's about 2 p.m. right now. And just kind of riding around. I rode the first 10 miles of the course and feels pretty good. There's some little ups and downs here and there, and it's mostly a pretty wide road, which is good considering probably how many people are gonna be racing. And it's super beautiful. I mean, there's just green trees everywhere. Passed by a lake. But yeah, overall feel pretty good.
So the next morning I was up super early, made some coffee and oatmeal, and yeah, headed over to the race start.
It's about 7:15, the race starts at 8. And just gonna get there a little early and line up. It's kind of like a start where everybody starts at the same time. It doesn't matter if you're pro or a beginner, everyone starts at the same time, so. Should be good. It's gonna be interesting to see how many people will be racing the course and what it's gonna be like. I mean, it's a neutral start for the first I think 10 minutes or so, and then it's basically free for all. I'm not sure how long it's gonna take me. This trip, it was all about the journey and just taking the trip, meeting new people and having fun. So it's not about the race result, because obviously I'm not like a pro or anything or some super athlete. I'm just here to have fun on the bike and yeah, a good time. To be closer
to you. Guys, ready?
It was a neutral start with an Alfa Romeo driving in front of us, since they were one of the sponsors, seeing that Valtteri was part of this whole event, which was super cool.
Have fun out there on the bikes, and we'll see you soon.
And then they drove off and things started to heat up, so I started to make my way towards the front, since I started pretty far back during the start. And I was passing quite a few people, and then I kind of stuck behind, I want to say it was a couple maybe that were racing together, and they were cruising. Like, I was passing them, they were passing me, and then I just kind of decided, you know what, it's probably best if I just stick behind them, and tactically better to roll with a group. We just kind of cruised, and then we made our way into a bigger group that was only a few spots back behind first place, like behind Valtteri. Like, I was amazed at how good Valtteri is as a bike rider as well. Like, that dude is fast, man. He's fast in a race car and he's fast on a bike. And yeah, we were cruising, we were with the bigger group, and then the first feed station came up and I was like, oh my gosh, I'm out of food. I'm definitely gonna need to stop and get some gels and things like that. So I stopped and my group just kept going. I was the only one that stopped. And so I grabbed food real quick and started riding to try and catch up to them. And I saw them in the distance and I was like, oh yeah, I think I can make it back. I think I can make it back. And I was giving it 95% just to try to make it back to that group. And I ended up didn't making it back. And the last 25 miles of that race was so hard for me. One of the hardest things I've done. My legs were cramping up. I knew that I had given it all in that first 25 miles, and I was like, this is gonna be tough. And then a few people passed me, but I just kept my spirits up. I was just stoked to be doing this gravel race and being in Finland riding my bike. Got close to the finish and was like, I'm just gonna give it everything I have this last like 100 yards so I can feel like I, you know, have a strong finish. And yeah, then I finished and I was pretty destroyed, not gonna lie. I was super destroyed, but I was so happy to have completed the race, to taken on this challenge for myself, and just to be in Finland, like I said, riding my bike. And it was truly an awesome experience, and I'm definitely planning on going back next year for the next edition.
So it's the day after the race. I'm feeling pretty tired right now, but it was a great time. My first gravel race ever, and honestly, one of the funnest things I've done on a bike, so I'll definitely be signing up for more. We're out here in Lahti on part of the course that I rode yesterday, and just wanted to come out here and show you guys how beautiful it is and what the roads were like. So we're just gonna get a couple clips now, and yeah, should be fun.
After that, I headed to Loma, which is an area that I have some family and family friends that live in, and stayed with them for about 5 or 6 days and hung out in the countryside. And then I did one other bike ride down to Helsinki, and that was my trip. It was an amazing experience, and I cannot wait to do it again next year. At least that's the plan. So thank you guys so much for watching this video if you made it to this point. This is my first time making a video like this, and I plan to do more because it's fun to me. I love riding my bike. I love making videos. I'm a commercial editor as my profession, but this type of video creating is a lot different from what I do for my job. So thanks so much for watching. I'll see you later.
So I will say the cool thing about Finland is that it is such a biker-friendly place. They've got these basically biking and walking paths all over the place alongside the roads, so they're nice and wide. You've got a safe place to ride and you don't have to worry about traffic too much in most parts. Okay, we're entering Helsinki now. Found a little bike shop cafe that I'm gonna have some lunch at. Looks pretty dope, so let's check it out.